Crafty family, how's everybody doing today? So, oh my goodness, I've got like an explosion in my house. An explosion, I tell you, it's an explosion. My DecoArt stuff came today. Yes, I am so excited. I can't even tell you, except the UPS guy was a jerk and he put it downstairs at my basement door. I don't know why he would do that. And I had to lug this like 50-pound box up my stairs and it kind of sucked. But other than that, yay, look at all this stuff. And you can't even see even this is just like nothing. So much stuff. You have no idea. There's just so much stuff. And DecoArts was so incredibly generous with their DecoArt Helping Artist program. So if you are an artist, a teacher, they like people who are, you know, either have a blog or a YouTube channel and also do teaching of their art or, you know, whatever it is. I do a lot of different stuff. I teach mixed media, you know, just crafts in general, just lots of different stuff. I do a lot of stencil work and teaching how to use stencils with different medias like modeling paste and all this other stuff. So that's what they want. People who are able to get out in the community and teach, and they might ask you to do demos here and there. So yeah, if you're interested in that and are, you know, and do some teaching and, you know, have a YouTube channel or a blog or both, the link will be below. You can sign up to be a DecoArts in their Helping Artist program, and you too can be sitting amongst an explosion of stuff. I'm gonna run through all this stuff as fast as I can so the video's not like crazy long, but it might be. I don't know. I tried to put everything, I did go through everything initially just because I needed to know what's in everything so to keep the video as short as possible. So anyway, I was able to order, you know, I think I got everything except for like one thing that I ordered, and that's fine. But yeah, so like for instance, I got this big bottle of weathered wood crackle medium, which is fantastic for putting on, you know, it's basically crackle finish, but it's a big bottle, to use for like furniture pieces, which I do repurposing of furniture and stuff. I just don't have the room for it here. Well, I have the room for it, but my garage is now loaded with stuff, so I can't do it until I move. But this is a big bottle of that I got. I also got triple thick, which I'm so excited to use because it's kind of like glossy accents, I believe. And it's also a finish, like a glaze. You can use it in both ways. And so I've got this big old bottle to play with. I'm so excited. You're going to be seeing a lot more DecoArts products in my crafting, which is awesome. I got a really nice, really, really nice paintbrush, which I'm actually going to open this really quick so I can show you. You're not going to be able to feel it the way I can, though. But let me tell you something. This brush is so soft. I mean, like, I haven't felt anything this soft. It's so incredibly soft. This is so nice for, you know, for doing various crafts. It's just such a nice soft brush. I love it. So exciting. And then I got pouncy brushes for stencils, which, let me tell you, I got tons and tons. I got an ass load of stencils. My butt hurts because I got so many stencils coming out of it. Then we've got image transfer medium. You're going to see me use this as well because I love image transferring. I do it a lot with Mod Podge, but this is supposed to be way better to do image transferring with, so I can't wait to show you this. Yay, fun! And then I got some dimensional effects, which is basically a texture paste, which is going to be fun to play with. And then I got pretty much all of their metallic lusters, which are pretty much the same as Inca Golds. I opened one of them just so I can see what it looked like and show you guys how cool that is. Very cool. So I'm very excited about these. I got this teal color. It's turquoise. I got Fab Fuchsia. I got Majestic Purple and Gold Rush and Copper Kettle and Orange Flicker, which will be great for Halloween and the fall. Black Shimmer. I got Silver Spark, Champagne Ice. Cosmic Blue and Iced Espresso. I was hoping there would be a light pink, like a nice shabby chic color pink, but the only one they had was Fab Fuchsia, and that's a bright pink. So maybe they'll come out with a pink. Who knows? Hopefully. That would be nice. So I'm going to try to move these out of the way and put them down here. I've got like a huge mess going on around here. Huge mess. Then I'm going to show you these cool tissue papers that they had. And they're really awesome. And they're going to be so much fun to play with. Aren't they cool? There's this flowered one. Then there's music notes. And then there's a couple of script. Yeah, I thought these were going to be a lot of fun. I got two of those to play with. My hair is like everywhere. So I got two of those. Let's see. Now we're going to get into some stencils. Stencils. Aren't these cool? These are the Andy Skinner stencils, which if you get the chance to go check these out, they are so badass. And you know what I'm thinking, right? Jelly plate. How much fun am I going to have with my jelly plate and these stencils? This is what I've been waiting for. This is why I even made my jelly plate in the first place, because I thought, oh my God, I have so many cool stencils coming. And I really don't have any stencils. I have about a handful of stencils, which there goes my dog. Are you done yet, Tigger? Quiet. I don't know if you heard that. Well, he's going to keep going, apparently. So I've got this one, which is like a snakeskin pattern. And I just love it. It's so awesome. I love this one, Code Breaker. This one's really cool. There's just so many cool stencils. Let me see if I can find all the Andy Skinner ones. There's this one, which is called Snake's Web. I should tell you what they're all cold. Cold. Yeah, I should tell you what they're all cold. No, they're not cold, but so that, you know, if you are going to be going into the Deco Arts Helping Artist program and ordering your stuff, you'll know what I got here, because it doesn't show you a picture of what they are. It just says the name of them. So these are the 12 by 3 Andy Skinner's mixed media stencils, and this one's called Shedded. This one's called Shedded. This one's called Code Breaker. This one's the 6x6, and this one's called Snake's Web, which I love. Here's another 6x6, and this one's the one with the mask. As you can see, it has the stencil, and then it has the part that's cut out of the stencil to use as a mask. And this one's called Children. And then this one here is just a regular stencil, 6x6, and it has the faces, and it's called Baroque, B-A-R-O-Q-U-E, Barque. I have no freaking clue. Something like that. This one's called Whirlpool. So cool. These are the 6x6s. This one's called Vogue, and this has the mask again. You could see what it looks like right there. And it's got the mask. So if you don't know anything about masking, we're going to be doing some upcoming stuff with the jelly plate and masking. Please don't mind my nails. I still have paint and crap all under my nails. I say that like every time, don't I? And this is Have Your Say, it's called. And it's basically an alphabet. This is another one with a mask, 6x6, called Hippie Chick, which I absolutely love this one. It's probably my favorite one. Then, let's see, what other Andy Skinner ones do I have before I go through the other ones? Because I kind of mix them all up. Okay, here we go. And then we've got these long 12x3s, and here's Faces. And I think it's called, oh, it's called Strike the Pose. But these are fun. So fun. And this one here is Route 66, because it says, get your kicks on Route 66. And it has, like, all kinds of cool stuff. This one here has got to be one of my favorites, called Old Film. And it's got like really cool, like, it almost looks like what's his name? Charlie Chapman? Oh, what's his name? Yeah, that's his name, I think. I don't know why that's eluding me. And yeah, so that one's really cool. And then there's this one, which is called Tread Carefully, which is like a tire tread. That one's badass. And then we've got some clock gears. It's called Incognito, because it's cogs. Hold on. So there's that one. And then this one's an 8x8, and it is called Sunburst. I love that one. It's so cool. And then this is another 8x8, and it's called Alphabet Spaghetti. I love this one. This is going to make a great jelly plate stencil for sure. And then I think that's all of the... Nope, I'm wrong. Hold on. There's more Andy Skinner. This one's my favorite. Day of the Dead. How freaking cool is that? You could see a better picture of what they look like there. Isn't this awesome? I mean, the detail in this is phenomenal. I mean, just crazy detail. This is going to be so much fun to use for Halloween. I'm so excited. And then we've got, this one is called French Elements, and it's got all kinds of French, you know, words, I guess. Very cool. This one's called Serendipity, and it has things like art, calm, create, dream, all kinds of stuff. Imagine, beach, you know, just cool words. This one's called Industrial Elements. Very cool. This one's called Tornado. Woo! Isn't that one cool? Okay, now we're done with the Andy Skinner, right? Now we're done. Okay, so these are now just the DecoArt Americana. Let me put that out of the way. Americana stencils. There's this one, and this is Daisy Chain, and it's a 6x8. That one's really pretty. And then we've got this, which is called Button Alphabet. That one's really cool. And then we've got this one, which is Dandelion. I love that. These are going to be so much fun to play with. And then this one's Pixelated. I love that too. And it shows you an example of what you can do with it. Isn't that cool? I think that's awesome. Awesome! This one is their DecoArt Personally Yours line. I have their 4 or 5 of these, maybe 6. And these have like really cool, I think there's 2 stencils in here. Yeah, there's 2 stencils, and those are the 2 that you get right there. I love these. These are awesome. And then there's this one, which is really cool. Yeah, these are probably my favorite aside from the Andy Skinner is these Personally Yours by Urban Ink or whatever. Or yeah, it says DecoArt Personally Yours Urban Ink. So I guess it's their like Urban Ink line, their kind of trendy line of stencils. And there's that one and that one. I just love these. And then I got 2 different alphabets. I got 2 different alphabets, which I absolutely love both of these. I think they're so cool. Those are going to be so much fun for making cool letters and words on things. I'll move those out of the way now so get to the next ones. This is the Americana Classics. And this one here is called Jacobean Floral. I love that. And this one here is called Royal Tile. A lot of these here that I'm going to be showing you now are great for furniture and decor, home decor items. These are just awesome for that. And I can't wait to sit down and do, or sit down. Huh, you don't sit down when you make furniture. But like they show you, you know, different tables and stuff. Like I can't wait to sit and like start doing stuff like that. Because I'm itching to make some cool furniture stuff. And this one here, these are the self-sticky. They're the stick-on stencils. And these are great for things that are like rounded or things that are weird shaped that are hard to get a stencil on, which is cool. And this is like a different polka dots, which I like. Very cool. And then here's another one with the self-sticky. Because this is fun for things like this where you can't, you know, it's harder to get a stencil on. And you can reuse them over and over again, which is awesome. And then I got a couple of these long ones to do like long furniture pieces. Or like here it shows like a lampshade and you could do like, you know, the fronts of dresser drawers or something or whatever. Very cool. There's that one. And then there's this one with the fleur-de-lis. Or like you can even do a wall above like a chair rail or something or above a door. You know, so these are great for that. I'll move those out of the way and we'll get to the 12x12s. I got a bunch of 12x12s. These are also fantastic for furniture. So much fun. Furniture, fabric. You can make pillows with them. You could do just so much to do with these. And like here it shows a canvas and then it shows a table, but this one's called Mandala This one here is called Postcard from Paris because it looks like a postcard or a stamp, I should say. It's very cool. This is probably my favorite one out of the 12 by 12s, the gears. It's called Gears and Cogs. This one's badass. This is so cool. If I was staying in this house, I would probably do something on my walls with these gears. And maybe this one. I don't know. This one's cool. It's called Segmented Swirls. I love this. And look how cute that is. So cute. And then the tray. I hope you can see these. I hope I'm not like screwing up. I don't have you zoomed in just because the stuff that I'm going to show you, I don't want to have to worry about being off camera. And then here's keys, which I love this one too. I would definitely use the keys if I was staying in this house and stencil some designs on my walls. Faux showa. And then I've got this one, which is cool because it's got several stencils or seven stencils. And you get all the alphabet. And then you get like this cool like frame looking one. Oh, so cool. I love it. So cool. And then this one here is called Dandelion. Oh, this one's called Quirky. Quirky Bizarre. And this one's called Vintage Keys. I don't know if I told you the names. This one's called Segmented Swirls. I did tell you that. And this one's Dandelion. This one's called The French Bakery, which if you see, very cool. Love that. I like all the French ones. This one's The French Inn. They have a lot of French, which I love. I love Paris, French, all kinds of stuff. I wish they had like an Eiffel Tower one. That would be cool. And then this one here is called Fishtail, which I love this. So cool. Look at the lampshade they did in that one. Very cool. This one I love. It's called Tie-Dyed or Tie-Dye. And I absolutely love this. This would make a fabulous like t-shirt without having to worry about actually tie-dyeing it and making a mess. You could just put this on a t-shirt, use fabric paints and do different colors. How cool. This one I love, Honeycomb. This is called Honey Wire. Sorry, but it's like a honeycomb. But then they show you some examples. How cute is that? Very cute. Love it. And then this one's called Old World Numbers, which I love this. This one here is called Greek Key. Love this too. This is an awesome pattern. This one is called Old French Script, and it's basically all French words. Isn't that awesome? This would be great for modeling paste, and they show like that there. I hope you're able to see it. And then last but not least, French Living. I know, I got a ton of French, right? And that one has all that stuff on it. Very cool. I'm so excited about my stencils. Okay, moving right along. All right, I showed you that stuff. I'm going to show you the Traditions paints that I got, which I'm going to try to get them all up here because I have several boxes of them. Sorry if my head's in the way. My hair is like an absolute rat nest right now. Okay, so this is all the Traditions paints, and I wanted these specifically because I love to sit down sometimes and just do an acrylic painting, and I don't have the best paints for that. I have the cheapy kind of, you know, folk art type paints that you buy for 50 cents, a dollar, whatever. These paints are their professional acrylic paint line, and I am so in love with this. These are fantastic, and they're huge bottles. I thought they were going to be the same size as the folk art bottles. They're the same height, but they're about double the dimension, or yeah, the circumference. I don't know why I said dimension. They're double the circumference. So they're about, you know, because obviously these have 3 ounces and these have 2 ounces. Oh, so they're not double. So they're just like more. It just seems like they're double. They're huge. So these are 3 ounce bottles and they're just amazing. Like this one is I think this is like a metallic color. It looks metallic. Let me see. Oh yeah. Look at that. Freaking amazing. Beautiful color. Just beautiful. So there's that. And then there's this color. That's beautiful too. Hold on. Okay. And then there is this, which is not the same, is it? No. I try not to get, this is quinacridone violet. And this is Crimson Permanent Alizarin. I have no idea how to say some of these names because these are professionals. So these are fancy pants. Fancy pants paints. And this is Quinacridone Burnt Orange. And True Silver, which I wonder if this is metallic. Oh, hell yeah. Which you can't see because I just, well, you'll see in the cap. I don't know if it'll show up. Very cool. Oh, they just look fantastic. This is Perrin 1 Orange. I have no idea. I don't know how to speak fancy paint. And then there's another box. And I've got Phthalo Green Blue and Phthalo Blue. I got Ultramarine Blue and Medium White. I got, don't know how to say that, Cerulean Blue. I have no idea. And Phthalo Green Yellow. I'm not sophisticated. I don't know how to speak fancy pant paint. Raw Sienna. I'm just going to call them blue. That looks like a goldy tan color. No, it's titanium white, raw sienna, yaller, gold, green, I don't know, marigold. I don't know. I'm just kidding. This is, Diary Lied yellow. Jesus. Chrome green hue. Yellow oxide. Hansa yellow. I mean, these names are just crazy. Raw sienna and titanium white. And then in here, we got white. We got like a orangey poop color. We got black poop color. We got brown poop color. And we've got like a reddish blue poop color for when you eat too many beets. Anyway, this is burgundy. Oh, that's an easy one to say. Burgundy, burnt umber, raw umber. Burnt and raw. Pick how you want it, honey. Do you want your meat raw or burnt? Quinacridone gold and light pearl. Ooh, that's got to be pretty. Ooh, yeah. That's pretty. You probably can't see, but it's very pearly. Love it. One more. This one is cobalt blue hue. Transparent yellow iron oxide. Aquamarine. Ooh, I like that one. That one is my favorite. Let's see. Dioxazine. Purple. Opaque white. And sapphire blue. Love it! Okay, so that's all of those, which I'm going to attempt to stack up over here and get out of the way. Alright, then we've got some mediums here. And I got crackle paste. Which, ooh, look at that. Yummy. I love mediums. Mediums. Can you tell me where my dead mother is? Please speak to me. Oh, you're not that kind of medium. Never mind. Texture sand paste. This stuff looked interesting. There's lots of grit in this stuff. Love it. That's going to be so much fun to play with. Get back on there. And then we've got modeling paste. And crackle glaze. Oh yeah. These are going to be a blast. A blast. Alright, where am I going to put that now? I have no room. I don't know where I'm going to put any of this stuff. Because honestly, I have no room. I have one shelf, possibly, that this stuff can go on. And I have to take down all my pretty stuff, like my big Eiffel Tower, and my big dress form, my iron dress form, my big pretty pink plate. All that stuff's got to be packed away in order for me to fit that up there. But that's okay, because I got to pack that stuff away anyway, because, of course, I'm moving. So, yeah. Okay, so then we've got sprays, and I made sure to get all their sprays, except for, wait a minute, this stuff. This is their liquid glass, which, again, is like, is supposed to be like, I'm going to have to figure out the difference between the triple thick and the liquid glass and find out what the difference is, because they both, as far as I've seen, are kind of like the glossy accents, but I'm going to try to figure out which one is kind of better for what. So I'm interested in that. And then I got all the sprays in the whole wide world, everything they got, because I wanted some sprays, man. I have a lot of homemade sprays, but I thought, heck yeah, I want to try some of their sprays. Now, some of these are shimmer, and some of them are just regular. So, I'm trying to see. separate the shimmers, not to discriminate, but I want to move the shimmers because I think there was only a few shimmers, like four, yeah. Okay, and that's all I got, right, of those? Yeah. Okay, so these are all their regular colors, and this is called Carbon Black, and this one's called Yellow Green. That's a pretty green. This one's called Primary Cyan, and this one's Red, and this one's Primary Yellow. Now, these colors I can pronounce, and this one's called Purple, and this one's called Primary Magenta, and this one's called Orange. See, now that's easy. And then we've got their shimmers, which, as you can see on the bottom, it's got the shimmer stuff. You can always tell a shimmer because it usually settles on the bottom. And this one's Yellow, and Turquoise, and Violet, and White. How cool is that? I'm so excited to use these suckers. Let's try to get them all back in the box so I can get them out of the way. Out the way, folks. Okay, move those back down by my feet. Okay, then, let's see. I want to say this is the last box that I got. Okay, last box is, I believe these are all the media paints, which I was so excited to get these for my jelly plate and for mixed media and for, you know, doing all that kinds of fun stuff, because these are awesome. And I'm just going to blow through and show you the media paint. They're 100% acrylic polymer, but they're good for, like, they're great for, like, on your jelly plate and for doing layering with your art journals and your mixed media. These are great paints for that because you can spread them out thin and then you can layer colors over top of them. Yeah, they're just really cool. And then I've got the interference paints, which I'm super excited about these. These I need to show you because you're just gonna die. These are so awesome. I have been so excited over these. I just need to find, because not all of them have the sticker on top. They should, shouldn't they? I tried to get all the interference colors because they appealed to me very much so. Oh, and then I got an antiquing cream, which I didn't realize was in there. Is there more antiquing cream? Yeah, there's a green one. Okay, there's this one. So these, in order to make these work, I need a black piece of paper so that you can see these. So hold on one second. All right, I only found this cheap, crappy craft pad. So that'll have to do. It's not exactly black. It's more on the gray side. Anyway, so these paints show up fantastic on... Like 10 minutes goes by so fast. Anyway, these paints show up fantastic on black, which I don't know if this is going to show up very well, but their color comes out on black. So this is the purple, and I don't know if you can see, but it has like a shimmer to it, and it's very cool. And they show up on different on white paper than they do on black paper. And they look white, and you could barely see that they have a color to them. And on white paper, you can't really even see them unless you... Well, you kind of can, but you're not going to be able to. You got to hold it a certain way to see it. It's going to be too hard for me to really show you these colors, aside from on black paper, which this is crappy black paper anyway. So these are really cool for doing different techniques with that I've... See, look how it shows up. It looked white, and then it showed up this really cool teal color. That's how they all are. Like, I'll show it to you on my finger this time. Look, it looks white. And then when you put it on the paper, it comes out like a... And you, like, move it with the light, it comes out like a pinkish color. I mean, it's just so cool. So anyway, I'll probably be learning a lot more about these and learning some techniques to use them. I've already watched a few things on it, as if I need more paint on my fingers and hands. So I'll learn more about this as time goes by so that we can learn together on how to use them properly. So yeah, that's all the stuff I got. It's a ton. It's craziness. There's just so much stuff. I can't believe it. But also I wanted to give you a sneak peek on some things I'm working on. Firstly, I made a tiny jelly plate. The reason I made a tiny jelly plate is to be able to put it on my acrylic block and stamp with it. How cool is that? You can paint real quick on it and put a pattern, and then you can flip it over and stamp in your journals and whatnot. That's what's great about having a tiny block. A tiny acrylic block is a tiny jelly plate is because you can use it as a stamp. You can put a design on it. I can use my texture cards to go through it with a design and then stamp different colors quickly. And, you know, that's cool. So I made that. And you make it the same as the other one. You just scale down the ingredients. That's all. And then I'm going to give you a very quick sneak peek on the project I'm working for, the design team project I'm working for Miriams Craft blog or crafting supplies. I am working on something and I finally cut into my graphic 45 papers. Yes, ma'am, I did. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. I cut into my Gilded Lily graphic 45 and I'm going to only show you this for a split second. So pay attention. Ready? Pay attention. Okay, that's it. That's all you get to see. And that is the shadow box that I'm working on. And you're going to see that soon. Actually, the first part is probably, the first part of that video is probably going to go up tomorrow. Because what I'm going to do is when I finish a part, like part one, I'm just going to put it up. And then I might not finish the other one for another week. So it's going to go up slowly. But yeah, definitely check out miriamscraftingblog.com, which is where you can find Miriam's crafting supplies. You can buy a lot of stuff from her and her prices are amazing. So I'll put a link in the description of this video as well. I will also put a link for the Helping Artist program. And yeah, so I hope you guys stay tuned because we're going to have some fun in the upcoming months and what have you. So yeah. Let me know what you think of my deco art stuff. Give me some ideas of stuff to do. What do you want to see me do with them besides eat them? Because I don't want to eat them again. Because last time I had to go to the hospital. And that's not good. No, I'm just kidding. I don't eat my products generally. Sometimes. Maybe. I don't know. Sorry, not sorry. I don't know. Whatever. I don't always eat my products. I don't eat my products. When I'm really hungry, I do. So anyway, off track. Let me know what you want to see me do. You know, juggle them. I could try. Here. I can't juggle. I actually can juggle. I just can't juggle bottles and I have to be standing up with balls in my hand, which really didn't sound good. Whose balls? I don't know. So anyway, let me know what you want me to do. You know, do you want me to, which products do you want me to test out first? Do you want me to do the transfer medium? Do you want me to test out the dimensional effects? Do you want me to find out and play with some triple thick and some liquid glass? Do you want me to use the interference paints? Do you want me to use the media paints on the jelly plate? Do you want me to use the stencils? What do you want from me? Oh my God, you guys are such a pain in my butt. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. So anyway, yeah, let me know which one of these products you want me to use first or, you know, whatever. Let me know. And I hope you guys have a great, great rest of your week and month and year and everything. And make sure you do what you love and love what you do. And be nice to everybody. I love you guys. I'll see you guys later. Bye. So as I was putting away my things into this basket, I realized I forgot something that was sitting off to the side to show you. And that was another box with some various stuff in it, like some gel stains. There is this color here, which is maple. There is Americana multi-surface metallics. I got that in chocolate metallic, which sounds cool. I got it in this gold metallic. I got it in silver. I got it in yellow gold. And I got it in champagne. Then I also got some Craft Twinkles, which is basically a glitter paint. I got that in silver. I got it in gold, black.
I got it in this sparkling pink. I got more gel stains in walnut, oak, more twinkles, a pearlizing medium, which if you mix with any paint, it turns it to a pearl color. And I found the rest of my interference paints were in here. I knew I had more of them, so there's a bunch of them. So I forgot to mention that stuff. Oops. So I just thought I'd throw that in there. So see ya.